Hello students, I hope you are good and you are enjoying the video learnings of 10th standard. So here again we are going to continue with the first chapter, heredity and evolution. I hope you have understood the importance of how heredity and the genetic engineering and content of genes came into the picture. That was the first part of the chapter, heredity and hereditary changes. Today we are going to talk about three important terms which many of will find it difficult initially to understand, but I'll try to make it as simple as possible because this is what you are going to use it in higher class also if you take biology in 11th and 12th. Even if you don't understand, don't get scared. You can revise it 2-3 times because the video is going to be there with you. And still if you don't get anything, you can ask me on a personal chat. So three terms are very important. What we need to understand today is one is transcription, other is translation, and other is translocation, all starting with T. Transcription, translation, translocation. Okay, before getting into the terms, let's try to connect back to again 9th standard, because as we know, we are connected to the earlier classes. Can you tell, they're asking, sketch and explain the structure of DNA and various types of RNA. Now, we have done this in life process, even in heredity part in 9th standard, but I know you won't be able to recollect anything right now. So to make your life easy, I have just, this is not just enough, but you can take help of your 9th standard, you can get into details. So basically, first question, the structure of DNA. We know that we usually draw the DNA in this format where we say that DNA is a double helical structure made up of two strands. So DNA is made up of nucleotides. What those nucleotides are there, we are not really interested right now. But we know that DNA is double stranded, two strands are there, and two strands are coiled around an imaginary axis. And the full form of DNA is what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. I'll repeat. Full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. Second thing they are asking is about the next important component inside the cell, that is RNA. RNA stands for ribonucleic acid. And what are the types of RNA? One is the messenger RNA called mRNA. Other is ribosomal RNA called rRNA. And third is tRNA called as transfer RNA. So what are the three types of RNA present inside the cell? Messenger RNA known as mRNA, ribosomal RNA known as rRNA, and tRNA known as transfer RNA. Now, before getting into the actual transcription, translation and all those part, let us try to first understand the difference between the DNA and RNA, because once the difference is clear, I think we would be able to understand transcription and translation in better ways. So, first point of differentiation is what? DNA is double-stranded, RNA is single-stranded, means what? DNA is made up of two strands. And RNA is made up of only one single strand or one single line, you can say. DNA is majorly present inside the nucleus. RNA is made inside the nucleus, but when it comes to use of the RNA, RNA is going to be present in the cytoplasm of the cell. Cytoplasm is outside the cell. DNA makes genes and controls hereditary characters. We know this. DNA is going to become the part of chromosome, and DNA is supposed to control the hereditary characters. And RNA is used by the cell to make up proteins for the cell. So what is the function, major function of RNA? RNA is going to help the cell to make proteins, whereas DNA is going to control the genes and hereditary characters. So I hope this makes this very clear. The function of DNA is making genes and transferring hereditary characters, whereas function of RNA is to make proteins for the cell. And RNA is of three type, mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. So with this understanding in details, let us first try to understand transcription, translation and translocation with help of this chart, and then we'll move on to the textbook part if some important points which are there in the textbook. So before getting into transcription, we know that I have drawn a cell here. Can you see the cell? So this is a cell. So what is this inside the cell, this circular part? obviously it's going to be the nucleus, and inside the nucleus these structures which are present are called as what? Chromosome. So I have drawn one chromosome here. If I open up a chromosome, I will get a thread-like structure, and this thread-like structure would be called as what? DNA. So such fragments of DNA are present on the chromosome which makes the gene. This is very simple. A chromosome present inside the nucleus. If I look at one single chromosome, if I open up the chain of the chromosome, I'm going to get this single thread-like structure, and that fragment of DNA would be called as gene. So I've drawn a fragment of DNA in a straight line here. Now what happens to this fragment of DNA inside the nucleus? What is this? Basically, it's a DNA, and DNA has all the information for making the protein inside the cell. So it's going to happen step by step. First is going to be transcription, where the DNA would be used for making an mRNA copy. And second would be whatever mRNA copy has been made, from that mRNA copy, new proteins would be synthesized that will be called as translation. I know it's very heavy to understand this terms and what is going on in the cell which we cannot see, but let us go step by step to understand this. So suppose this DNA which is there, now this DNA two strands are there, these two strands open up, and one of the strand is having a nucleotides A, adenine, T, thymine, G, guanine, C, cytosine, and so on. Four nucleotides are there, no? A, T, G, C, it can come in any sequence. So I have drawn it in a simple way. A, T, G, C, A, T, G, C. So these are the nucleotides present on the DNA. So out of the two strands, only one of the strands of the DNA would be used for making the mRNA. I'll repeat, out of the two strands, only one of the strand would be used for making a making a mRNA. And that process is called as what? Transcription. So suppose if there is an A in the DNA, there will be complementary nucleotide to the A would be U in the U in the mRNA. If there is a T, there will be A. If there is a G, there will be C. If there is a G, there will be C. So wherever there is an A, there will be U. Wherever there is a T, there will be A. Wherever there is a G, there will be C. Wherever there is a C, there will be U. And this new strand of mRNA is made, and the process is called as transcription. So whatever information DNA was having, from that information, a new copy of mRNA is made. And this new copy of mRNA, the process is called as what? Transcription. I hope this makes it very clear. Further, now what will happen to this mRNA? This is inside the nucleus. It will come out from the nucleus in the cytoplasm. And this mRNA will be used for making a protein. How this mRNA will be used for making a protein? On mRNA, these nucleotides are present in a group of three nucleotides. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, so on. Suppose if I write it here, U. So this becomes third. So this group of three nucleotides would be called as codon. Codon means it codes for something. So many such codons are present on mRNA. So on this mRNA, the ribosome will come inside. The circular part is called ribosome. The tRNA would come with a proper amino acid, because proteins are made up of amino acid, and it will read one codon. So one codon, one amino acid. Then this ribosome will go on to the next codon here. It will jump from this codon to the next codon. Then the next amino acid will come and join. Now this jumping of ribosome from one codon to another codon is called translocation. I'm making it very clear. Jumping of ribosome from one codon to another codon is called translocation. And similarly, many such amino acids would be joined. And finally, whatever information present or mRNA will be translated to protein. And that is called as what? Translation. So making off of mRNA copy from DNA is called transcription. Making of protein from mRNA is called translation. And jumping of ribosome one codon each on the ribosome, jumping of ribosome one codon each on mRNA would be called as translocation. So I hope these three terms are very clear. Transcription is making of mRNA. Translation is making of protein. And translocation is moving of ribosome one codon each on an mRNA is called as translocation. So even if you understand this much part for today, I hope we'll be able to continue this and get it into details about some important part from the textbook in the next class. In the meantime, I'll request you to go through this video at least 2 or 3 times and read the textbook simultaneously so that your doubts would be clear. And still, if you have any doubts, please let me know on the WhatsApp chat so that before I continue with the next class, I'll clear your doubts first and then we'll go ahead. As I'm telling you again and again, this part is not that easy. Until and unless you read the textbook thoroughly and try to understand and see the video 2-3 times till you understand, you are not going to get it. So request you to again read and see the video till you understand and ask the doubt as and when they come. Till then, thank you. Bye bye. Take care.